thank Joan for putting this together and everybody that helped. And I want to thank my helpers, Barbara Meyer and Mary Lombardi, who were here at 8 o'clock this morning and hanging the show. And I want to thank Gayle for coming by. I just want to point out that the art show is all of Jeff's photographs. And Walter Weeks did a fantastic job of putting that together, organizing.
So the musical program is on the wall, and I will give you guys a little booklet. I'll hand those out to those who don't have it so you can keep track of the different acts. If you want to catch someone in particular, then just walk around and be loose and have fun.
All right, please welcome Gayle Mason.
I don't speak to the microphones very well, but I just want to thank everybody for coming, and you just touched Jeffrey's heart, and we miss Jeffrey, and I miss him so much, and thank you for getting me through this. Thank you for helping me move. Thank you for the music. Thank you for the art. Just thank you for everything. I had something written out, but of course I can't do it. But thank you so much for everything.
All right, everybody give it up for Carl Wurzelbach getting this day kicked off. Hi everybody, my name is Carl Wurzelbach. Start these things. I never know, we've all got so many feelings inside of us and you don't know where to take them or what to do. And the most difficult thing about losing anybody is you don't know how much you miss them till they're gone. And you walk around and wherever you go, they're not there. So anyway, the thing is that you don't know how much you miss somebody till they're not there. Okay? Jeff was everywhere. In an event like this, he'd be over there taking pictures, and he'd be over there taking pictures, and he'd be behind you taking pictures. Then you'd see a picture and say, how the hell did he get that picture? I didn't even see him in that spot. He was like, yeah, this is the right demographic. He was like Savoir Faire. He was everywhere, you know? And I'd go to an art opening, and he'd be standing there next to the artist, talking with them. The next thing you knew, he'd be taking pictures, and then he'd be everywhere again. Jeff was everywhere. I love that about him. Then we'll watch the Jeffs. You're going to hear about all the Jeffs as we get through the day here. My favorite Jeff was Guitar Jeff. I love to watch him play guitar. I honestly mean that. I watched him when he got the guitar and then he started playing. He was so serious, right? He'd study, and it was great because you would watch him like watching a dancer, okay? Because he'd have moves that he'd do. You know, he'd have that one where he'd be real serious, and then he'd have that other move, and then he'd go up. He would do all and I would feel better watching him play the guitar than when I walked in. It actually made me feel good just watching him play. He had the ability to do that, and that's my favorite part of Jeffrey, is doing that. What I'd like to do is share a song I wrote. It's about, I know Jeff loved his guitars, and over time I've come to love this guitar. I didn't realize I did, but I do. So this song about from one guitar player to another guitar player, and it's called This Here Guitar. It goes like this. This here guitar taught me how to sing a little song. Showed me how to sing the blues. This here guitar
Agassi, my friend Jeffrey.
Where I stop and I do my favorite Jeff Mason story, okay? I don't know about you, but Linda and I have been locked in the house for about 2.5 years, and we haven't done anything. Anywhere we've done anything, something called COVID, I don't know if you've heard of it or not, but really messed us up, and we didn't go out, and then one day, saw that the Jeff Mason band was playing in Westerly, and I was like, wow, I gotta go there, I gotta see this. So we went to the stage, and Jeff was in that pre-performance state that a lot of us get in. It's like, don't go near him. It was just like, oh, he's gonna play it even wrong. So anyway, the band started to play, and they were really good. I'm tapping my toe, I'm bopping my head, the band sounds really, really good. And I'm noticing that there's a very interesting sound on Jeff's guitar. And the more I listen to it, it's a little strange, but it's kind of neat, and it really works. And I thought it was a really brave selection of guitar tones to play in a band, but it was really, really cool. So anyway, I went up to him after the show, and he was all messed up. His spirit was vexed. His amplifier had malfunctioned, and none of the tones that he wanted to get were coming out of the guitar. And he was crushed. And the two of us talked, and it was a really interesting conversation, because here he was, having played, having everything gone wrong, thinking that he was sucked, right? He was beating himself up. And I said, that wasn't my experience at all. I said, my toe was tapping, my head was bopping, and I'm watching you play, and it was great. I really liked that tone. And what we came to understand was that what happens with people a lot is that we play the drums when we find a really nice chair. And it's okay. If the spirit moves you, it's a good thing. That's good.
Wow. That's your replacement.
The thing that we discovered in our conversation was that sometimes you do stuff that you think really sucks and it's bad. And you have no idea how other people perceive it. And it's really wonderful and it really, really touches them in a deep spot. And it's really important to get a second opinion from somebody when you're talking to yourself and you're talking to kids. So anyway, that was my conversation with Jeff, and it was the last time I spoke to him. So it was a really important conversation that I wanted to share with you. And the song goes on. I went down to Westerly, cause I loved to watch him play. He grabbed his guitar and he got on stage, and then it rocked the day away. Playing E, playing G, playing F, playing C, you know it really didn't matter what the key would be. I watched him pick, I watched him strum, I listened to Jeff's guitar hum. Literally. Playing his guitar. Now, it's time for a quick mathematical equation. Jeffrey plus Gayle equals crazy love. Crazy in love with one another, still are a wonderful thing. I salute you for that. What I was going to do, I thought Jeff would like if I played Gayle's favorite song. That would be an appropriate thing. So I'm going to sing this song for you. It's called Fat Charlie. If you don't know the story, I'll tell you the short story. Long ago at ETG, there was a songwriter circle. And one of the assignments was to go home and write a song about an animal. Okay? And I didn't know what to write about. And I'm sitting there, and I look down, and I have three cats. They're all looking up at me, going, okay. Okay. Anyway, I got three cats looking up at me saying, Mimi, what the hell did you just hear? Anyway, I have no idea what to do with these cats. I don't want to write a song that upsets one, because if you have cats, you know that if you get a cat upset, they pee on everything. So I literally do not want to piss off these cats, okay? So I'm sitting there, I'm trying to figure out what to do, and it dawns on me that if I meditate and open my head and open my soul, I can ask one of these cats to come in and write a song, and then I can blame it on whoever writes it, and I wouldn't have to be responsible. So, I do this stat. I empty my head, which is very simple to do. I may do it 2 or 3 times here yet in the length of this performance. But I do that, and when I come to, I have this lovely song called Fat Charlie, okay? Written by Fat Charlie, who was talking about himself. What else would he do, right? Imagine being daddy. egotistical. Anyway, why is it happening is, at this point in the show, I normally conjure up Charlie and I let him possess my body and sing the song. Problem is, about 3 weeks ago I did this, and Sam Kinison wound up in my body. And it was, I don't know what he did, but I have three friends that are still in intensive therapy because of it. So, now I get to sing this song as me to you, Gayle, and I hope you appreciate it. It's Fat Charlie. And it goes, and there's a video if you like. If you go on YouTube and punch in Fat Charlie, you'll see it's kind of neat. It goes like this. My name is Charlie and I'm called Cat. I'd love to eat, you know that why I'm so fat. Chicken, turkey, tuna, it don't matter to me. Just keep on filling up my boat and I will make it empty. I'm Fat Charlie. Where's my chow, Fat Charlie? Could you feed me now, Fat Charlie? Dude, where's the food, Fat Charlie? Hey, thanks for dinner, could you pet me, please? Makes me want a perfect kind of week in the knees. You know I love it when you're hungry and I sit on your lap. Feet are so doggone good, I think I'll take another nap. I'm Fat Charlie, please do it again, Fat Charlie. I will be your best friend, Fat Charlie. Where's the food, Fat Charlie? Did I say I love to sleep? If I got nine, let them all be just like this one. Ooh-wee. I got two sisters, they're a pain in my paws. I understand the term insanity clause. They live till first, they say they never belong. But there ain't no way I'm leaving, I'll keep singing my song. I'm Fat Charlie. And I'm staying for good, Fat Charlie. Girls, this is my hood, Fat Charlie. Dude, where's the food, Fat Charlie? I love to poop, watch the poop. Betty Hill, there's watch call Scooby. If I got nine, let them all be just like this one. My name is Charlie and I'm Cross Cat. I love to eat, you know that's why I'm so fat. I'm Fat Charlie. Please, that's my name, Fat Charlie. Come on, sing it again, Fat Charlie. Dude, where's the food, Fat Charlie? Fat Charlie. Yeah, 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 Fat Charlie. Love, no friend of mine.
Thank you.
Let's hear the Pumba.
You want to tell them about the tune?
This is a song by Ray Davies. It was on Us Welcome to Liz, but the thing that really kicked my ass was when I heard it done by the Preservation Hall jazz band. I've just been thinking a lot about the trip that we all took to. What magical time. As many things, and many times I was still joking with them. And Gayle said that Jeff liked our album, which picture. And this is from that album. It's complicated.
Yeah.
By the way, the t-shirt, Keep Your Head Up, comes from Preservation Hall, New Orleans, which is dear to us. And the saying is, you have to keep your head up, otherwise you won't see the angels. And you know he's here, right?
Yes.
You know, you can feel that he's here. It's not just the work around the world. It's all of you.
The second song that we want to do is, I hadn't thought about it for a long time. It's by John Sebastian. And it made me think about what a great songwriter John Sebastian is. That he wrote this song right around the time of Woodstock. And yet it's still relevant now. So I would like to sing this song for my friend, my brother from another world.
I was going to do two songs. One of the songs I was going to do was
So we done by the person before, but it's left. And now you have those songs. But we're going to do it anyway. By the band, Dylan's song, by the band, by everybody in the world who's done it. The band did the most in 5 different keys, modulated, you name it. And we decided to do it this way. Streets of Rome are filled with rubble. Nations were priests are everywhere. You get all those things that you see in double. On a cold, dark night on the Spanish day. Got to hurry on back to my hotel room, where I got me a date with a pretty young girl for free. She promised to be right there with me. When I paid my masterpiece. Spent inside the Coliseum, dodging lions and wasting time. Those kings of the jungle, I can hardly bear to see them. Yes, it sure has been a long, hard climb. Train wheels running through the back of my memory. When I ran on the hilltop, following the bank of Waukee. Some name will sound like a rhapsody. When I paid my masterpiece. Sitting in a dirty gondola. Oh, to bang back in the land of the gondola. Well, I left Rome and landed in Brussels. Oh, so bumpy that I almost cried. Clergymen in uniform, young girls pulling muscles. Everyone was there to greet me when I stepped inside. News fame and memory began had to be held down by. Well, I paid my masterpiece.
Day Night are the Snugs, of course. But filling in on drums today is Gayle. Our drummer and our keyboard player are out of state. They gone. Forget about them. Okay, so today we all have Jeff Mason next to our hearts. And that's what Jeff Mason was in our life. As Gayle knows. And he was a great Snugs fan, a great chronicler of all of the Staten Island creative community musicians and artists. If they ever make a book about Staten Island for the last 10 years, it would be filled with Jeff Mason and Walter Weeks photographs.
Oh, thank you.
Wherever we played, they were there. Okay, so Jeff was my buddy.
Thank you.
will meet again someday, my friend. But not in this life. Until then, we'll meet again someday, my friend. But not in this life. Don't want to relive every moment of some other's life. To call it sacrifice is twice as nice as suicide. If he woke up on a park bench, every bamboo went. Oh, had died. Ran the clock.
That Jeff loved. loved Patty Griffin, and I've sung this song for him, and he loved it. And it's very hard to do, but I'm going to try and make it through. Thank you. Patty Griffin song. If you don't know Patty Griffin, you should check it out.
And she played it up here on the 9th fret. That's why I ended up.
All right. This one's called I Can Get There. Time I could just get away. You seem to want me to. I have learned in life that I should take care. Rushing in love will get you nowhere. So I go slowly to.
Beautiful song.
because life, even when it ends, it's always a celebration, because we keep all those people in our hearts. And Jeff loved music, as we all know, and made music and made beautiful art. He was a celebrator.
I do love drawing, so that's the thing. And then we also are big fans of any new notes. And yes, this is a song of mine, but I guess as close as I get to any new notes. It's called What's in Your Heart.
Absolutely mine.
countryside. We don't need a place to hide. Hey, babe, where you going? I don't know. Eyes will close, the rest is true.
Thank you.
Great American Songbook, so.
Water. or at least the Jeff Mason band will lead with this one song. Never gonna listen. John Kelly.
Song in the Maverick, so in that spirit. hope you'll dance.
Jeff
here too, and I know he would have loved it. Thanks a lot for supporting us to put this thing on. Thank you.
Thanks for coming out on what you could have been doing, going to the mall or any of that other shit. So thanks for hanging out.
Gayle sends a big thank you.